The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Chapter 6, verses 53 onwards. After making the crossing to the other side of the sea, Jesus and his disciples came to land at Gennesaret and tied up there. As they were leaving the boat, people immediately recognized him. They scurried about the surrounding country and began to bring in the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. Whatever villages or towns or countryside he entered, they laid the sick in the marketplaces and begged him that they might touch only the tassel of his cloak, and as many as touched it were healed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends, the first reading from the book of Genesis, we saw the creation story. God the Creator and the universe is his creation. St. Thomas Aquinas, he says, looking at the creation, we can understand the Creator. We saw whatever God created, they were all good. And we know the top place occupied by man, human being, mankind, that is the best of all his creation. And the Lord said, everything he created good. That is why we have in the Bible, it is said, God created us good. If there is something evil in us, that is our own creation. Don't blame God for that. God created us good. Because of our carelessness, because of our disobedience, because of our selfishness, we made ourselves evil. So, we should repent and return to our original condition. You know, some people, they look at a flower and they say, how beautiful this flower is. If the flower is so beautiful, what about the Creator? Looking at the universe, maybe a tsunami or things like that, we know how powerful it can be. If that is so powerful, what about the Creator? Creator is much more powerful. So from the creation, we can understand the Creator, and we need to worship the Lord. Because he is all powerful, he is all loving, and he is beautiful. So that is the understanding we should have, the realization that we should have as God's children. Reflecting on the gospel we have listened today, we can see Jesus coming to a place. As he was landing, people recognized him. And then we can see him, we see them running to different places, gathering the sick people, bringing them on the mat and laying them before Jesus. Whenever he moved, maybe from one place to another, they went to that place. They were looking for Jesus and they recognized his power. And as a result of that, a lot of people got healed. Today, maybe we don't see that healing happening. What must be the reason? Is it because God is not powerful as he was? God is not interested in healing us as he was doing before? No, that is not the reason. We failed to recognize Jesus. We failed to recognize his power, power of healing. And that is why we miss that healing today. So as we go through this celebration. Whenever we celebrate Mass, let us try to recognize Jesus. As we think of the early Christian community, they did not need any healing prayer. All what they needed was celebrating the Eucharist. And in the Eucharist, celebrated meaningfully, they were receiving lots of healings. So, the Holy Eucharist, that is something that can simply give us healing, love, and salvation. We should recognize Jesus in the Eucharist so that on a daily basis we can also receive healing from Jesus. Today, as we go through this celebration, we pray for this grace, we pray for the anointing of the Holy Spirit in our life. Thank you.